Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to explain how you can check a number for palindrome, right? So I will be explaining how to read a number. Then I will tell you how you can check whether that number is palindrome or not. So before starting, I want to share one information with you. So if you go into the detail of this video, you will find links of various playlists which are related to different topics of C programming. So you can watch them. Now coming on to the topic. So I will be explaining this with the help of C programming. So here you can see two scenarios are mentioned. So first is number is 123. Now we need to identify its reverse so that we can check the palindrome. So its reverse is 321. So in case of palindrome, if original number's reverse is equivalent to that number, then that number is known as palindrome. So here 123, its reverse is 321. So 321 is not equal to 123. So that's why it is not a palindrome. Then here number is 121, its reverse is 121. So both are equal. It means this number is a palindrome number. So now we will implement this program in two parts. First, reverse of the number will be calculated, and then the reverse will be compared with the original number so that we can check whether it is palindrome or not. So now I'm going to start writing the program. Then I will explain each and every step with the help of these two examples so that you can understand well how it is working. So here you can see I have declared four variables. N will be the original number. REV will be storing the reverse of the number. Then two more variables are there, T and A. So use of these two variables will be explained further. Now, with the help of printf, this message will be displayed on output screen. That is to read a number. So enter a number message will be displayed. Then with the help of scanners, I am reading that number, the input number into n variable. So the number which is entered by the user will be stored inside this variable. Now I am going to write the logic so that I can calculate the reverse. So I am implementing while n greater than 0. Now inside this while loop, I'm going to write the logic. So first I'm writing all the statements, then I will explain them one by one. So this is the logic which will calculate the reverse, right? This is for calculating reverse. So now, first of all, I'm going to explain this so that you can understand how we are performing reverse of a number. So let's say I'm taking example as number is 123. So here I'm writing the variables value. So initial value of this number is 123. Now I'm going to rotate this loop. So number is greater than zero, condition is true. Then we need to calculate this. So if we calculate this, so here you can see it is written n modulus 10. So n is 123. When we take modulus of any number with 10, so it always provides last digit of the number. So new value of a will be 3. Then here you can see I am multiplying reverse into 10 and adding a into it. So right now you can see reverse is not having any value and we are multiplying it with 10. So if a variable is not having any value and we multiply it with any digit, so it will provide garbage value. So we need to avoid this. So here I am putting this reverse equals to zero. So initial value of reverse is zero. Now zero into 10, zero plus a. So what is the value of a? It is 3. So new value of rewards will be 3. Then n equals to n by 10, so we need to divide n by 10. So initial value of n is 123. If we divide it by 10, so remaining will be 12. Because whenever you divide any number with 10, let's say 123, so it will be this 12.3. And you can see all the variables are of type integer. So integer don't store this value which is available after point. So this will be removed and only 12 will be stored inside n. So this is the first rotation of this while loop. Now again we need to repeat this. So right now n is 12. 12 is greater than 0, then 12 modulus 10. So remainder will be 2. That will be stored inside a. So new value of a is 2. Then calculate this. Right now current value of reverse is 3. So 3 into 10 is 30 and add a. So a is 2. So it will become 32. So new value of reverse is 32. And then again divide n by 10. So its new value will be 1. So if we divide 12 by 10, so answer will be 1.2, and because of int, we can have only 1. Again check the condition, it is again true. So again n modulus 10, so n is 1. 1 modulus 10 will provide remainder as 1. Then reverse is 32, so 32 into 10 is 320 plus a. So a is 1, so it will become 321. So new value of reverse will be 321. Then divide n by 10, so n is 1. So if we divide 1 by 10, so it will become 0 point something. So n will be having 0. So this way, if next time we iterate this loop, so n is 0, 0 is not greater than 0. So this condition will be false. And after termination of this loop, now you can see in reverse variable, we have reverse of the original number. So original number was 123. Now we have reverse as 321, right? So now you can compare this 321 with this n variable, right? So after completion of this loop, we need to write one if condition. So here we can write this. If n double equals to reverse. So this statement will come just after completion of loop. Then if it is true, you can print. You can print palindrome. If it is false, then you can print not, or you can write a complete statement, not palindrome. And then you can finish your main function. So this way it is completed now. So let's check. There is a simple glitch that I want to resolve now. So after completion of this loop, we need to compare end with reverse. So reverse, you know, it is 321. And if we see the value of n, so it is right now 0. So after completion of while loop, after completion of this while loop, reverse will be having reverse of original number, but n will automatically become 0 because we are dividing n by 10 continuously inside the loop. So can we use n here? No, because n is always 0, so it will always print not palindrome. So now what is the solution to this problem? So before starting this loop, we need to take backup of n. So that's why I use this t variable here. So before starting the loop, I am assigning n into t. So it means before starting of this loop, variable n was having 123. So 123 will be assigned into t, and then inside this loop, we are just dividing value of n by 10. So n will decrease to 0, but its original value will be saved as a copy into t. So here in place of n, you can use t to compare it with reverse. So t has original value, that is the input provided by the user. REV or reverse variable is having the reverse of that number that was available inside the n. So if now this condition is true, then it will display palindrome, otherwise not palindrome. So right now, if we see first example, so t will be having 123 and reverse will be having 321. So both are unequal. So it will print not palindrome. But if n is 121, so its reverse will be 121. So it will display palindrome. So this way, I hope you understood how we calculated whether a number is palindrome or not. So first we converted the original number into its reverse, and then we compared both actual number and its reverse. If they are equal, then number will be palindrome. Otherwise, it is not palindrome. So I hope you understood whatever I explained in this video. If you want to watch more programming related videos, you can go to my channel, open playlist. So where various playlists related to various programming languages are available. And I uploaded more than 1000 videos. So do follow my channel so that you can learn programming in easy way. Thank you for watching this video.